Like, 5-year-old Evan Wallace wouldn't be alive today without stem cell transplant technology, says her mother. At the age of 3, Evan was diagnosed at the Stollery Children's Hospital with a form of leukemia and bone marrow failure. A donor was found in the International Cord Bank and transferred to the young cancer patient.
And she got her transplant on her dad's birthday, March 29th, 2012. She had very little issues, and once the chemo was done, we had to keep Evan in isolation. So we moved everything to the room, into the room. And we cycled in there. She did play jokes on the nurses, and even she played dead on April Fool's Day for the nurses. She was just 4. It was special.
Now, Edmonton's Lois Hole Hospital for Women will collect and store umbilical cord blood, increasing the chance of treatment for thousands of patients across the country. Edmonton mothers will be able to donate to the public cord bank in 2014.
Just to know there's other options, because when you find out your only option is stem cell transplant, then you're depending on other people. So this just brings more things to the table for you, I guess, right?
So we've been working with the provincial governments to put together a business case to build the bank. And one of the things that we were able to do to persuade governments to fund that business case was we agreed to raise the first $12.5 million of the $48 million program through a fundraising campaign.
Starting next year, expectant mothers will be asked to sign a consent form to donate the cord blood as part of a testing phase to ensure quality before the bank launches later in the year. The Lois Hole Hospital is one of the 4 hospitals in the country and the only one in Alberta to serve as a collection site.